It all began in chapter 10 of the Acts of the Apostles. A man decided to enroll in the military and then he became a soldier for the Roman government. He was a Roman by birth. And by God's grace, he rose through the ranks and became a centurion, an officer. And because he now became an officer, he was posted, stationed away from home. So far from his home in Rome, he was sent to a place that we know now, in Jerusalem. He was sent to a place in Caesarea Philippi. So as we hear, this man, being an officer in Caesarea, now finds something new. All his life, he had been working and conquering for a king, an emperor. But one day, he realized that God also was working to conquer him. How does this come by about? One day he has a vision that God is telling him that he has somebody he's sending to him. This man was not a Jew, not a Christian. But if we read Acts chapter 10, we hear that the man I'm talking about, Cornelius, was a devout man. He prayed every day, number one. Number two, he was generous because God had made him rich. So he shared his gifts with others. So in being prayerful and being generous, the favor of God came upon him. If you ask me, Father, how do I win God's favor? These are the two things. Be prayerful and be generous with what God has given you. These two ways to earn God's favor. So this man, not a Jew, far away from home, met God. You see, Jesus even meets us when we are far from home. He may be here, he may be in life, and you think that you are far from home in terms of your spiritual work with God. Yet, like this man Cornelius, God still counts for those who have gone far from home. So far from home, being prayerful and doing good works, Jesus came to him. He sent a man to him, Peter. Now we know. So the reading we have heard is what happened when Peter got to his house. So Cornelius, a simple man, a rich man, a soldier, meets Peter. And we hear the opening verses of chapter 10, verses 26, we read that when he saw this man, Peter, he decided to fall down before him, bow before him, to worship him. Then the first words of Peter were, "Please, get up, stand up, because I too am a man, like you. So I'm not a god." These words are beautiful. Unfortunately, in our times, in our own days, we have men of God who are thinking, or rather, making people believe that they are gods. No matter how gifted you are, we are all men. May you not follow any man of God who portrays himself as a god, because he's still a man. Peter, a man of humility, told this man, "I'm not a god." Cornelius had never seen Jesus before. He has never met God before. So for him, Peter's presence brought him God's presence. He wanted to worship him. Peter said, "No, I'm a man like you." He prayed for the gift of humility. Peter was a man of humility, a humble man. The little thing we know about Peter's life is that, getting to the end of his life, he wrote two books. They are First Peter and then Second Peter. I guess you know them, right? And if you read the first lines of his First Peter letter, he said that, Peter speaking, "From Peter, apostle of Jesus Christ." First Peter, chapter 1, verse 1. Which was written some years before he died. Now, just some few years, just before he died, he wrote his second letter to Peter. And you know how he began? This time, "From Simon Peter, servant and apostle of Jesus Christ." Peter has gotten the beauty of life. That, look, all life is about is that come to know that you are a servant of God. Amen. So Peter now addressed himself as not just Peter, Simon Peter. But he knew that before he became Peter, he was a what? A Simon. I guess you know that Jesus gave him the name Peter. Each of us here is like something like Simon Peter. We have our Simon natures and our Peter natures. Simon nature is what he was giving birth to. His sinfulness, his weaknesses, the things he does around, which he doesn't want to do. But the Peter nature, Peter power, I should call it, is what Jesus gave him. that a sinful man, an uneducated man, had become used by God, a man of God. Our sermon natures should not stop us from the Peter powers in us. So you all have those characters, those natures. Let us identify them. Don't let the Peter power, your Peter nature, what God has made you today, blind you from your Simon nature, your past. Always remember that before Simon, before Peter, there was a Simon. You all have that. So Peter says, look, from Simon Peter, a servant of Jesus Christ. And then it goes on to say that when this man Cornelius had received Jesus in the presence of Peter, Peter made a statement that, oh, now I know that God has no favorites. Christ the King. Are you aware that God has no favorites? Hello. That is also very enriching. Because if God has no favorites, then you can earn God's favor. That is it. If God has favorites, then means that our coming here will be useless because He has already chosen those He means to bless. But no, that's so true. He has no favorites. So we can all earn and enjoy His favor, His blessings. So don't count yourself out. But Jesus doesn't mean to count you out of the equation. You are part of it. He has no favorites. He says, any man, any woman who does the will of God and obeys them, he is the one who has God's favor. And that is ours. Today, as we mark Mother's Day, we pray for prayerful mothers like Cornelius and generous mothers who have given us their love. We pray that, like Peter, we children who are born to mothers may also be humble no matter how God has raised us. We also pray for everybody here in this chapel that God help us to know that before we can enjoy His blessings, we should know that we all have our backgrounds. Yet, like Peter, he asked to our Simon natures and gave us the Peter powers. May we grow in faith in this Easter season, even as we pray for the Pentecost novena, which will bring us to Pentecost eventually. Amen.